Hi guys, this is Neha and welcome back to our channel about technology. In this video tutorial, we'll be talking about one of the network layer protocol, that is RIP, Routing Information Protocol, which is responsible for routing a packet from source host to destination host. So let's get started. Being a network layer protocol, RIP is a unicast routing protocol, that is, it is used to establish one-to-one communication, which means there will be only one sender and one receiver in the communication. Moving ahead, we learn that RIP is an intra-domain routing protocol. So, it would perform routing inside an autonomous system, which is controlled by a single administrator. RIP supports classful routing, so it does not support subnetting, and thereby it does not support VLSM, that is variable length subnet mask. In RIP, we calculate metric or cost of routing path using hop count, which means when a packet travels from router 1 to router 2, it takes one hop count. When packet travels from router 2 to router 3, it takes two hop counts. When packet travels from router 3 to 4, it takes three hop counts. The path with minimum hop count is chosen for packet to route from source to destination. The maximum number of hop count allowed in RIP protocol is 15. That is, a packet must not make more than 15 hop counts to reach the destination. Corresponding to maximum number of hop count, network using RIP protocol must have only 16 routers. RIP also supports load balancing. We'll discuss this topic in a coming slide. To update the routers present inside an autonomous system with the information of routes in the network, RIP has two kind of messages, request message and response message. Request message is sent by new routers entering into the network to gain information about their neighboring routers, or it is even sent by the routers that has some timeout entries in their routing table. Further, the response message is classified into two types, solicited response message and unsolicited response message. The solicited response message is always sent in response to the RIP request message. The unsolicited message are either sent at regular interval of 30 seconds to update the routers regarding the routes in the network or in case there is any change in the network. To regulate the sending and receiving of RIP messages, each router in RIP network has three kind of timers with them: periodic timer, expiration timer, and garbage collection timer. Talking about periodic timer, it controls advertising of regular update messages. That means, for each particular route, a router sets a periodic timer of 30 seconds. After every 30 seconds, router receives an update message for that particular route. And after the updation is done, this timer is set again to 0. Now, let's talk about expiration timer. It observes validity of a route, which means whenever a router updates any route information, it sets an expiration timer of 180 seconds. We know that a route information is updated after every 30 seconds, but if it doesn't happen, and even if this counter reaches to 0, then the route is considered as unreachable. Moving towards garbage collection, it aware you about the invalidity of a route prior to purging, which means whenever a route becomes unreachable, the router doesn't immediately remove that route from routing table. Instead, it sets a timer of 120 seconds and wait for 120 seconds. And when this counter reaches to 0, the route is removed from the routing table. Now, let us discuss a working example of RIP protocol. You can notice there are 8 routers in the network, that is from router R1 to router R8. Now, a router R1 has a packet for router R8. If the packet takes route 1, that is via R2 and R3, it has to perform 3 hop counts. If packet take route 2, that is via router R5, it has to perform 2 hop counts. If a packet takes route 3, that is via router R4, R6 and R7, it has to perform 4 hop counts. So, RIP will choose the path that has minimum hop counts, that is route 2 with 2 hop counts. Now, let us talk about load balancing feature of RIP protocol. Consider if there are three routes with same minimum hop count, that is two hop counts, then the route will send packets from all the three routes to balance the load on the network. So that's all guys. Hope you find the video interesting. Please like and share this video and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel About Technology. Keep checking the channel for further updates and put your comment and queries in the section below. We'll be back again soon with a new video. Till then, take a good care of yourself. Bye-bye.